Good morning. I think today we'll be discussing on module 4 of computer networks and security. This particular module will be talking much about the security aspects in the network system. I believe the security in the network system plays a very, very important role. Since from the day of evolvement of the network, security has been has become an issue, and it's very inevitable to give the security to the communication, because whenever we make communication from one person to another person, so the security plays a very, very important role. Suppose if two people are talking, then also we'll look at around that whether this discussion is being observed by anybody or listened to the other person or not. Similarly, in the network, when two systems are making communication, the privacy of that communication is limited to the two systems. If the third party is trying to access it, or they are trying to intrude into the network, so that is supposed to be trapped and stopped. Only then we can ensure the privacy of communication, and then only the communication will be more effective. That's the reason the security plays a very, very important role in the computer network. And today we'll be discussing on various aspects. This network security has different flavors to discuss. Firstly, we'll be discussing an overview of network security. The basic elements and threats are discussed. Then the overview of security methods, the different methods of security will be discussed in detail. After that, we'll be discussing on the encryption protocols. You know, the security can be offered only by means of encryption. So that the encryption becomes very, very important. There are two levels of encryption protocol. One is secret key encryption protocol. The other one is the public key encryption protocol. So both we will be discussing in detail with a few examples, so that you can understand the encryption technique, and also will understand how the protocol work. Then another important aspect is authentication. Security is basically defined by means of an authentication also. So authentication plays a very, very important role to identify the persons who are in communication. And that is done by means of message digest and digital signature. And even today, the digital signature has made its own impact on the communication, and hence, the digital signature is a very, very essential part of this communication. After that, we'll be discussing about the security of IP and wireless network. You know, the security in the internet goes with respect to the type of communication. IP communication is one kind, and the wireless network communication is another. More or less, the wireless network communication is more vulnerable for the attack, and hence we need to give sufficient security to the wireless networks. Finally, we conclude our discussion with the firewalls. Any network that has been connected to the internet will have a gateway. That gateway will be taking much responsibility of giving protection to the communication of the network within the LAN. So that is why the firewall plays a very, very important role to protect any LAN network. So that's why the firewall will be one of the very basic security issues. Let us move on to the basic security, network security elements. There are two elements that will play a very important role that will really offer you the security for communication. The first one is confidentiality. What is the confident meaning of the confidentiality? So information should be available only to those who have rightful access to it. It means that there are two people of communication, and only these people are held responsible for such communication. There won't be any third party who will listen to that communication, so that the confidentiality of that communication will be failed. So the basic idea here is to provide the confidentiality for communication. So you need to see that only the authenticated people will be making the communication. Authenticity and integrity. Wherein, the sender message and the message itself should be verified at the receiving point. I have sent some message to the destination. Whether that message is being received in a correct form or not, and it is being received by the right person or not. So this plays a very, very important role, so that the integrity of the data that has been transmitted to the destination is taken into consideration. So these two will play a very, very important role in making any communication. I think that will ensure the security. There are so many means of giving the security in the computer network. We will be discussing firstly how the different securities are offered. You can see here an example where the security can be, how best the security can be offered. Just a minute. You can look at this first figure. Here, an user one wants to make communication with the user two, and he has sent a message, I am user one, saying that I am user one. So it is expected that this message is received by the user two directly. But however, there are possibilities there an intruder come into picture. Intruder is nothing but an unwanted person in the system to listen to that communication. But unfortunately, he is capturing this message in between at this point, and he will be altering that message and he will be sending that to the destination. Either he may alter it, or he may totally change it, or he can do whatever he wants. You see that I am user one was the message actually sent by user one to the user two. But however, the intruder has hacked this network and he has changed the message as, hey, I am user one. Here, the word hey is added. It may not be a proper pronunciation to the user two, but however, the intruder has introduced that word and he has transmitted. So finally, the user two is not receiving the exact statement of the user one, rather the modified statement of the intruder is being accessed by the user two. So this is where we say the security breach has occurred. It means that there is no security or privacy of communication between user one and user two. What could be the solution for this? You see, there is one technique here. It is mentioned with this example. User one will make a communication. I am user one. Okay. After he does this communication, there will be an encryption system is adopted. Okay. An encryption is done with the help of a key. We'll discuss what is key and all in the later stage. But an encryption is done with a support of the key. And after that, you can see this, the message has become this one. What is this? I think you can read the character, but you cannot really understand the message out of this sentence or statement. Okay, so this is an equivalent to this. But this can be understood only by the receiver, that is user two. Otherwise, if an intruder is in the network, he may access this message, but he is unable to understand what is this message is. And such a message, which is converted from readable to non-readable form, is called ciphertext. This is called ciphertext. So this ciphertext is generated by means of an encryption using some key, and the intruder is unable to read this message, and it remains to be a question mark for the intruder to understand this. So that finally the receiver, the actual receiver or authenticated receiver, user 2, will receive the right information on the other side. So I think this is how exactly we can provide the authenticity and the integrity of the message that has been transmitted from an user 1 to the user 2. Hope you are understanding the concept of network security with this example. Let us look at the threats to the network security. I think there are four different possible categorized threats out there. The first one, we call it as a DNS hacking. I think you must be knowing that DNS stands for domain name system. This is one of the very basic system protocol, which will help to navigate or to resolute the expected destination address. Okay, so this domain name system hacking will lead to lot many problem. For every communication, DNS is very essential. So that the very basic intention of an hacker is, if DNS is attacked, so that they can trouble the people in the network to a highest extent. That's why they'll use this as a tool for their hacking. The next one is routing table poisoning. I think this is another biggest challenge in the network system. You know, the routers will be used in the network to forward the packets in the network in the right direction at the expected quality of service. But every router will maintain a table in order to understand the topology of the network and also give service to the packets that have been received at each router point, so that the packets will be transmitted or forwarded to the destination in a right time. But what the trouble is done by an hacker in this case is, he will do the table poisoning, routing table poisoning. The meaning of poisoning is, the routing table will have an information of the topology of the network. Now he is corrupting this routing table, so that the corruption in the routing table will mislead the router to forward the packet. When it will mislead the router, the packets will be forwarded to a wrong direction. That will lead to so many problems in the network. So this is another biggest challenge, and how to avoid this has to be thought. And finally, the third one is packet mistreatment. So again, here the packets that are forwarded in the network will have some basic control information, what we say the header information. These header informations will be attacked. So there might be a sequence number, there might be an timeout, timestamp, there might be an source and destination addresses. Any correction or any changes made over this will lead to the mistreatment of the packet. Even the flag bits, so which will be altered here, an acknowledgement bit might be a reset, so that the understanding of that packet will be totally different. Likewise, there could be a different kind of attacks that is possible with respect to the the packet mistreatment. All these three techniques of attacking are called an attack over the network infrastructure. This is one category of attack. The other category is attack onto the end system. Either the sender or a receiver may be attacked here. So the target is either the sender or the receiver. That's why it is called an end system attack. And this kind of attack is called denial of services. More oftenly, it is mentioned as DOS. The denial of service, basically, the sender or the receiver will be attacked. And if it is an attack over the sender, the sender data will not be transmitted to the expected receiver. Or otherwise, if it is an attack over the receiver, so the receiver will be hidden, and so many other operations are done so that the packets may not reach the expected receiver. Rather, the receiver might be made as a busy person all the time and is unable to read the packets. So there might be a flood of SYN packets. There might be a chance that wherein they will block the receiver to a great extent. So this will lead to unreachability of this receiver, might be on a server, so that finally the user will unable to access the server, and hence that will make a big trouble to the receiver. So I think you might have heard about this kind of attack earlier days. There might be an attack on Amazon server, might be in the online shopping you do. If you on those days when Amazon has offered very good prices to the people, so usually during those days there will be a big rush to the Amazon online shopping. I think if the attacker attacks onto the server with the denial of service, I think it's a big or great loss to the Amazon online shopping, and that will lead to the total troublesome to the customer and also to the seller. So these are the different type of threats that are possible in the network system. Let us go with the DNS hacking attack. I think domain name system hacking attack is a kind. Usually the domain name system is used to make the resolution of the destination address. What do you mean by resolution? Basically, the domain name system will translate the addresses. Usually what we do is the user will be giving an high level address, like I may call it as www.gmail.com. This is an email high level address. This address will have an IP address. It means that the server of Gmail will have an IP address. Accessing this IP address is enabled the user to reach the IP address in the internet. Sorry. This is usually done by means of an UDP queries to the DNS server. There will be an exclusive server called DNS servers, which will give this service of converting from one form of address to the another form, because they will be having the complete database of these addresses in their network, and they will be trying to give such solution. And the basic services or examples for this are email service or might be navigation of a particular website. However, this will be attacked in two ways. It will be trying to attack to weaken the data authenticity, or they will try to attack to lack make the integrity weak. So these are the two possible attacks. I think this right side example will give you how exactly this DNS system works. This is the high level address that is requested, response from the DNS server will be like this. Okay, so usually the HTTP request and responses are used, and there might be a chance that the attacker will attack and he will change this IP address. Suppose I have requested a Gmail server, and this might be the response from DNS server, as this is the IP address of Gmail. But unfortunately, if this 226 has become 228, then what happens? Totally, it will be addressed to the different system, and the user is unable to reach to the expected Gmail server. There might be another intention where he is not really transferring the user call to the Gmail server. Rather, he may be given an IP address of his own system so that it may be reached to the hacker system, where he may do many mischievous things with respect to the request of the user. So that's the basic threat in case of DNS hacking system. There are four hacking attacks in DNS. The first one we say the information level attack. The second one is masquerading attack. And the third one is information leakage attack. And fourth one is domain hijacking attack. Let us discuss each one in detail. The information level attack is an attack. It will force the server to correspond with other than the correct answer. You mean in the user has made a request and the server will have to send the response to that. This response message might be changed, or otherwise this has changed because the request itself is changed by the system or the hacker. So that is why it leads to the cache poisoning. It means that I was requested to the Gmail server, okay, and you believe it or not, the hacker has changed the response. Okay, rather than Gmail server, he might have given Yahoo server address, so that the cache in case of the gateway, usually in any LAN network, gateway will be having a proxy server. This proxy server will have the cache, and this cache will maintain these addresses once it is accessing Gmail. So it will maintain that information in the cache, and that will be used repeatedly by the different user of that LAN. If suppose that address, Gmail address, has become an Yahoo address, and it is the total poisoning of the cache, every time the LAN user accessing for Gmail will be accessing the Yahoo, and it will annoy the user to use it. So that's the basic problem in case of this system. And hence, it's very, very essential to avoid this information level attack. Then the second one is masquerading attack. It is just like pretending like the other party. The hacker will make a middleman attack, wherein he may be trying to give some wrong information to the user. For example, I think more oftenly, I have seen that this kind of an attack has happened over the banking system. Suppose the SBI is requested, the online transaction is trying to be done by an user one with the help of DNS information. What exactly it happens here is middleman will change this address of SBI. Okay, so rather than the actual SBI, he will give the fake SBI address. Fake SBI address means he might have his own SBI page in the another server. This address is given to the user. Ultimately, further he will access this one, and whatever the basic information, confidential information of this client, like the user ID and the password can be captured by this fake system by the middleman attack. So this is a most dangerous one. Once he grabs your SBI account information like user ID and the password, later he can do anything with your account. So that's why this is a basic problem, and this is a very challenging system in the network to avoid this kind of attack. So obviously you need to be very, very careful in looking, because sometimes you may unable to see the page that has been accessed by this server of the hacker will be similar to the SBI, but it will not be exactly true. That is why all the time when you do such access, you look at the URL. So watching the URL is very, very important for you. That will give you the actual information about how exactly the URL appears. Is it really sbi.co.in or something else? Okay. So you have to be very, very careful on that part. So this is the second way of making the attack over the DNS hack. The third one is information leakage attack. Attacker sends the queries to all the hosts and identify which IP addresses are not in use. I think this is another basic problem. He will attack onto the user only. Okay. He will be attacking onto the user, different users, by sending queries to the different hosts, and he will trying to find which are all the hosts that are not in working condition. Such host addresses, IP addresses, are captured by the attacker. And these IP addresses are misused by the attacker. How? Very simple. Let me understand. A host or a server, which server? Let me take, for example, the Flipkart server is temporarily not working. He will try to identify it. And after that, the IP address of Flipkart server is used by the attacker. Okay. He will use that IP address, and he will bluff the customer, and it will be misused. He might have his own products showed, and the order may be received. Once the order is received, he may be claimed for the payment. Once the payment is made by the user, he will not be in the scene. Okay. Finally, what happens is, by doing this misuse operation of IP addresses, he will be getting the benefit of money, and at the same time, it is the bad name to the Flipkart, because people understand it is the Flipkart that has collected money, but they are not given you the service. That is why this has led to the black mark to the big organizations. So that's why this kind of an attack is supposed to be very, very carefully handled. And most of the time, you have to avoid the possible attack by means of sufficient security to your server. So that's the most important part of our network system. So next, we'll talk on to the domain hijacking attack. Whenever a user enters the domain address, he or she is forced to enter into the attacker's website. That's what I told you. It will be irritating and causing the loss of internet usability. I think you might have heard many of a time that most of the websites are attacked, and the attacker will make some changes in the website. For example, I have the VTU server at this address. Okay. If an attacker attacks onto VTU site, and he may change the home page of the VTU website. Okay, so he will be hijacking the entire domain address of the VTU. Domain address is ac.in, and he has redirected all requests of vtu.ac.in to his own home page. And there, instead of the VTU home page, he has created his own home page, which will really irritate the people to access it. I think recent day you might have heard that the Pakistan has done lot many such websites attack, and they have changed the Indian organizations websites are hijacked, and they might have replaced the pages of website by some other pages. All this happens very oftenly. See, in spite of a lot of security offered by the system, so still such attacks are going on. So that's why these kind of an attacks are supposed to be handled very, very careful. So in total, the DNS attack is a great attack, which will lead to lot many problem to the users, and probably the user will be losing the authenticity and also integrity of their data. So you have to take care of this attack very seriously in the network system. Let us move on to the second type of an attack, that is called a routing table poisoning attack. So usually the routing table poisoning attack is an attack over the what we say the routers in the network. I think I have told you the routers will have some table maintained, and this table will give the information about the neighbors of the router, because we say it is the learning of the network. So each router will try to understand who are its neighbors, and also how it can reach the destination through a particular neighbor. So that is learned by the router. So all this information is available in the routing table, so that this will help in forwarding the packet in the right direction. Suppose this is the destination, and the router has receives a packet to reach this particular destination. It after analyzing the routing table, it will understand that this is the router to which it is to be forwarded, so that it can reach this one. Suppose you assume that this router table is attacked and this data is altered. To reach this destination, it may give the address of this particular router. Okay, and hence what happens, finally this will forward this packet to this one, which is supposed to reach the destination D, but unfortunately this will have no path to reach the destination. So the packet will be lost finally in the network. So this is the basic problem that can happen in the in this type of an attack. So that's why this is basically, really we say it is the very difficult form of attack. So maliciously modifying the routing information updates sent by the router, and it leads to the congestion and an overwhelmed host, or otherwise sometimes the looping of packet is also possible. There might be a chance there illegal access to a particular data is also possible. And finally, we say the network partitioning is possible. What do you mean by network partitioning? So the right now in this example I showed you, the data, instead of forwarding to this side, it has been forwarded in the reverse direction. Okay. Finally, there will be a no connection between a part of this network and this network. So this will lead to the partitioning of the network. Always these packets will be redirected in the other direction. It never reached this part of the network. So this is called partitioning of network. I think this is the biggest challenge for the packets to reach the destination. And there are two types of attacks in the poisoning of the router. One we call as the link state attack. The other one is the router attack. So let us discuss each one in detail. When it comes to the link attack, the hacker gets the access to the link. I think you must be knowing that between any two switches or the hubs, there will be a connecting link. This will be a simple link between two switches. So this will be just carrying the packets from one point to the another point. So the hijacker or the hacker will get the access of this link, and thereby he will intercepts or otherwise he will interrupt, or he might be modifying the routing messages on the packet. That's the first possibility with the link attack. The second one is, it may attack on the link state and the distance vector protocols also. I think you might be knowing that when we are trying to find the path from source to destination, there are two basic algorithms that are being used. One is link state algorithm, the other one is distance vector algorithm. I think the approach of these two will be slightly different, but however, the link attack will affect both the link state algorithm and also distance vector algorithm. The router may send incorrect updates about the neighbors, so that there will be a totally wrong information with a particular router, and it will remain silent even if the link state of its neighbor has changed. See, as I told you earlier in the previous slide discussion, if this is the router, it will be learn about all its neighbors in the network, so that how could it reach the different destinations. Okay, all that will be so. You can see this router will learn about all these different routers or neighbors, what we say, okay, to reach any particular destination. What is the best path to reach? That is supposed to be understood by this. But however, there might be a chance in case of link attack, wherein this router will be unable to find the address of this neighbor, or if this neighbor address has changed, then it will not update that in this routing table, and finally it can never reach the expected destination. So this is the basic problem in case of link attack. There could be another possibility resulting in a link state link attack will result in lower throughput. Obviously, what do you mean by throughput? Throughput is against transmitted 100 packet, how many packets are received by the destination in time. When is it possible to reach the destination? When the path is really giving the sufficient support for the packet to reach the destination. But unfortunately, when the attacker attacks onto the link, he will be trying to redirect the packet. Either he might be redirect the packet to the different destination, or else he might be trying to keep the packet in loop with the network. So it may be in the loop of the network, and it never reaches the destination. So this will lead to the low throughput of the network, and hence the performance of the entire networks will go down. Finally, it will create a chaos in the network. I think this is the biggest problem that the intruder can create in the network, entire network. This is all the kind of an attack that can be expected from the link attack. The other one is the router attack. This router attack is another kind of an attack wherein the link state routing protocol, it is adding the non-existing links. They may add the non-existing links so that the routing table will be having wrong information. Okay. And it may delete the existing links, or even it may change the cost of the link. What do you mean by the cost of the link? Let us assume that I want to reach the destination from this point to the this point so now what I am doing is I will never go in this direction. This is source and this is destination. Okay, so what I do say is this, to reach this destination, this link has got higher cost and this link has got lower cost. Always the packets are forwarded in this direction. So finally it will loop back, or otherwise it may lead to different destinations. Okay. So finally it may either reach the destination or otherwise it may not be. Even if it reaches the destination, the total time taken to reach the destination will be too high, so that the packet becomes inefficient in the network. So this is the another problem that may happen in this, and it may cause a router to simply ignore the updates of the sent by the neighbors changes. There might be changes in the topology of the network, and this is learned by means of neighbor communication. If the router is made not to learn about the neighbor, he will simply ignore the neighbors, and hence the updations are not possible. Again, that leads to the problem. And then the distance vector protocol, the routers to send the wrong updates about the any node in the network. I think once a wrong information goes, obviously further routing becomes inefficient. The moment that the routing becomes inefficient, the total network communication will be upset. So this is the biggest challenge that happens in the network. And finally, the network will not be efficient. And a malicious router can send the wrong information in the form of distance vector to all neighbors. This is another problem. The neighbor itself is giving a wrong information. Rather saying that you go to the fifth router to reach the destination, it may say that you go to second router to reach the destination. So obviously it leads to the problem. I think you might have seen in sometimes a stranger visiting a city will be asking for some address. Probably that address is very nearby to the location where he is inquiring, but a person who will give a wrong information, No, this address is not here. You go to the next extension where you get this address. So if they do that, probably that person has to search for the another extension, and he will spend much time in learning about the actual address of the system. So this is all about the routing table poisoning attack. There are two types, link attack and the router attack. Both will lead to a lot many problem in the network, and these kind of attacks are supposed to be really stopped in the network. The remaining type of attack, like the packet mistreatment attack, can be discussed in the next class. Thank you. Thank you very much.